to discuss new topic, that is resources and development. But before starting the concept, we are going to discuss its definition, that what do you mean by resource, what are resources. So everything available in our environment which can be used to satisfy our needs is termed as resource. जो भी ऐसी चीजें हमारे एनवायरनमेंट में अवेलेबल हैं एंड देन दे कैन सेटिस्फाई आर नीड्स, जो हमारी नीड्स को पूरी कर रहा है, हमारी इस नीड को सेटिस्फाई कर रहा है, इट इज टर्म्ड एज रिसोर्स. इसका मतलब है रिसोर्स, कोई भी ऐसी चीज जो हमारी जरूरतों को पूरा करे, हमारी नीड्स को फुलफिल करे, इज टर्म्ड एज रिसोर्स. नाउ वी कैन क्लासिफाई रिसोर्सेज इन टू वेरियस कैटेगरीज. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी डिस्कस ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ ओरिजिन. On the basis of origin, we have two resources. हमारे पास दो resources हैं. The first one is biotic resources. As the name suggests, biotic resources, these are obtained from biosphere and have life. It include all the living things. इसमें सारे living things आएंगे. For example, human beings, flora, fauna, fisheries, etc. These are the examples of biotic resources. Then the next category is of abiotic resources. Now what are abiotic resources? Abiotic resources are those resources that do not have life. It comprised of non-living things. जितने भी आपके non-living things हैं वो इस category में आपके आएंगे. That is abiotic resources. And the examples are rocks and metals. We have done the classification on the basis of origin. So first of all, we have done its definition, that everything in the environment that satisfy our need is termed as resource. After that, we have done its classification. First of all, we have done on the basis of origin. On the basis of origin, we have two resources. The first one is biotic resources. Biotic resources are those resources which are included, which include each and everything, especially living things which have life. For example, human beings, flora, fauna, fisheries, etc. Second, we have the abiotic resources. It comprised of non-living things, that is rocks and metals. Now we are moving towards on the basis of exhaustibility. As the name suggests, exhaustibility, जो खत्म हो सकते हैं. On the basis of exhaustibility, we have two. The first category is of renewable resources. As the name suggests, renew. That it has the capacity, it has the tendency to renew itself. It can renew itself, it can replenish itself. So the resources which can be renewed itself are known as renewable or replenishable resources. For example, wind, water, forest, etc. These are the examples of renewable resources. Now the second category is of renewable, non-renewable resources. These occur over a long geological time. It takes millions of years to form non-renewable resources. The examples are fossil fuels, minerals. These are the examples of non-renewable resources. So this is done for today. We have done resources, its definition. Then we have done its classification on the basis of origin and on the basis of exhaustibility. Thank you so much.